Well, the big question really is that will 2020 be the year of mid-caps? Do you see the rally broadening at all in January itself as we start the run-up to the budget?
Yes. Only thing is, if we are too dependent on the FII flows, then probably we might continue to see the large cap outperform. But as and when we see a broad-based domestic rally, then the mid-cap and small-cap indices definitely have a long way to go, because in the last 18 months, as we all know, the underperformance has been quite sharp. And the fact that the RBI is now very serious on bringing interest rates down and making sure that transmission happens will impact the mid and small caps the most, because they have the most leverage out there.
Mihir, hi, good morning. Mid-caps normally do well in a declining rate scenario, but what would be the themes then? Economy-facing stocks, what would you back? Because, you know, 2 years of narrow market, if the hope is that it will expand in 2020, what will be the big themes?
So the good thing about the mid and small caps is that you have those segments and sectors which are not reflected in the large cap indices. For example, chemicals, some of the capital goods stocks in automation. We have a lot of good mid-caps pharma stocks to choose from, healthcare, those kind of like media, for example, multiplexes and all those segments are growing irrespective of whether the broader economy is doing well or not. So these segments are reflected in the mid and small cap indices, and there is always ample scope for stock picking there.
Okay. Amir, hi, good morning and happy new year to you in advance and to your entire team. It's been an uninterrupted bull market for some of these private sector banking names like ICICI Bank, up over 50% this year, and as we speak, sitting at a fresh high. You think 2020 will continue to be their year, or will the leadership change?
So I think the broad theme of private sector banks continuing to do well will continue. Because on one hand, as we just discussed, RBI is making sure that transmission happens, and we do see source of fundings for banking and deposit rates to come down, which should help the banks. But on the other hand, earlier it was very narrow and we had these NPA issues. So some of the private sector banks which had, say, 40 to 50% corporate exposure were not so favored. But as far as those bunch of private sector banks are concerned, the NPA issues are way past us. Enough provisions have been made, and these are banks now again getting back onto the lending path. So I think it will be a more broad private sector led bank rally. Earlier it was the private sector retail banks, but now even the private sector corporate banks will do well.
Okay. You know, you said that if you're only dependent on FIIs, then you can't expect the broad basing. Now, you are best placed to say whether the domestic investor is as interested as he was, for a better part of 2017-18. We saw that number coming down a bit, the equity flows into mutual funds. What is your sense about December? Was that a one-off in November? How was December for you?
For us, it's business as usual. So the insurance industry has been seeing steady growth. So we may not see the 25-30% growth that we saw, say, about 12 months back. But definitely, we are well on track to do the 15-20% growth in terms of overall. So I think as far as the domestic SIP flows are concerned, there is no problem with that. It's probably the chunky discretionary flows which will probably follow the momentum. And the way the global and local markets are holding up, it does look like that the momentum money will also come into the picture next month.
Okay, the two big triggers for this market in the month of Jan and Feb are the earnings season and the budget. Which one is a more important trigger for you, and what are you expecting from it?
So in the earnings season, there are unlikely to be too many surprises, because there has been a lot of negative news, and pretty much everybody knows about the segments and sectors which are doing well and not doing well. So it will now boil down to what the budget is going to look for. There are already lots of speculations on the tax rates, and of course there's a separate parallel track going on the GST rates, etc. So those events will most likely be more important than the earnings season.
Okay. By the way, just look at PVR for 2 days now, and on Friday also pointed out the stock. Today also it's the one which is seeing quite a bit of build up in futures as well. It's a fresh high for PVR. Remember on that day of AGM, when everyone talked about the death of companies like PVR, it was 1300, 1400, and since then it's been just a one-way rally for that stock.
Actually, I guess the fogs and difficulty of traveling has made people sit back at home.
And then movies doing very well, right? Good
movies.
News, the new
2000 rupees was the price. it's ridiculous. But anyway, you like some of these movie exhibitors? They're only two listed, of course. But any your thoughts on this space?
So it is a secular space to be in, as we talk about consumer discretionary and and the disposable income theme. I think these are trends, and the industry has consolidated very well. So it's a good balance of pricing power that the industry has, and people are uptrading. So as you mentioned, the 1,000 rupees tickets and 2,000 rupee tickets. There is a segment out there which will continue to grow.
Mihir, you guys have the advantage of thinking really long term. So are you all now looking at real estate? Are you looking at NBFC? So, the sectors that have been stressed for some time now.
So we are not looking at the stressed part of those sectors, but the companies which have now emerged stronger and are able to gather liabilities, and in the case of real estate, able to raise debt or equity, those are segments which will, or those specific companies will do much better than before, because like the multiplex segment that we talked about, there's been a lot of consolidation. Even in the real estate sector, there will be a lot of consolidation, and same for the NBFCs.
And in the private bank space, these two guys are running up Kotak faster than HDFC Bank. Would you look at the mid-cap private banks?
Yes, selectively, definitely, because as far as banks are concerned,
some of them are troubled even over there.
Yeah. So as we mentioned, the private sector banks which have taken enough provisions, and most of the large banks in the Nifty have taken good amount of provisions in the last 3 to 4 years. So we are pretty much past the NPA issues as far as those segments are concerned. So those will continue to grow. In the mid-cap private sector banks, we probably need to be a little more selective.
Are you concerned about valuations at all in some of these NBFCs? As we speak, Bajaj Finserv has hit a new high. It's up 50% for the year. Would you be cautious here, or do you think that these quality names will continue to rise?
Well, like it or not, I think the liquidity-led rally will continue to, prefer the so-called quality, visible growth kind of a theme, whether it's in the NBFC space or the FMCG space or even the banking space. So that theme is likely to continue. As I said, as long as we are seeing the markets rally on liquidity, it will be probably limited to these quality names and the large cap names.
Okay. Well, speaking of valuations, one part of the financial stability report which did not receive enough headlining is that the report also says that valuations have become more expensive for India vis-a-vis other emerging market peers, and now earnings better catch up to justify the valuations. It is our moment of irrational exuberance, perhaps, coming from all the regulators put together. It's not just an RBI report. There is a SEBI voice also in that, and the NIRDA voice. Valuations, how scared are you? Are you, alighting from any of the trains that you boarded in 2019?
Not really. In fact, in the last 3 to 4 months, we have probably increased exposure to equities, which is maybe a bit contrary. But the fact that two things happened at the same time, almost at the same time. One is the September 22nd tax cuts. And around the same time, the Fed also changed its stance and started expanding its balance sheet again.
Yes.
So now the Fed has increased its balance sheet by $400 billion in the last few months. So that kind of liquidity is something that we can't stand against, and that's what's driving the whole market.
Do you guys do any dealer checks or any checks on what's happening with the auto industry? I'm sure you guys are invested into many of those stocks. What is your view now? Have you increased exposure recently because of the, the green shoots that we're seeing?
We increased exposure after the Diwali numbers, the Dhanteras numbers were pretty exciting. And it looks like the rate of negative growth is coming off. Mm. So that delta is positive, I would say. Though you may see flat to negative growth in some segments, but the rate of that negative is coming down. And of course, the way stocks had corrected, they always tend to be a little ahead of the actual numbers.
So which segment did you increase exposure in?
Both cars and two-wheelers.
Okay. And what about your own sector, insurance and AMCs. AMCs, some of them went through the roof. You still like them?
We do like them as a business, but because of the valuations, we have been trimming a bit on the AMC side.
Okay. And insurance side?
Insurance, we continue to be neutral to a little bit overweight. We do see that space offers a little more choices, I would say, in terms of valuation range.
What do you think is the big risk to this bull market?
I think the big risk will be on the global front, the Fed stopping its QE. Mm. They're not calling it QE, but it is actually QE. And on the local front, these past few weeks have seen a lot of negative noise on the political front, and we have, you know, also seen some anecdotal evidence of tourism in Goa crashing and tourism in Agra crashing. So if that kind of negativity continues in the run-up to the budget, that can be a dampener for the markets.
Some sectors can be affected, of course.